In today's video, we're going to go over 7 steps that you can take to tackle your AP Environmental Science exam. By the end of this video, you're going to have a game plan that will help you score a 4 or a 5 on your APES exam as long as you stick to it. Before we get started, this video is brought to you by Albert, which provides hundreds of practice questions for all of your AP prep needs. So if you haven't already created your free account, use the link in the video description below to get started today. Without further ado though, let's get into today's tips on how to prepare for your AP Environmental Science exam. The first step that you need to take when it comes to preparing for your APES exam is to make sure that you take time to take a full-length diagnostic test. This is going to take you at least 3 hours to complete, so make sure that you plan accordingly. The purpose of this diagnostic test is for you to get exposure and familiarity with the different sorts of sections as well as questions that you can come to expect when you actually take your real APES exam. To access some practice tests, you can use some of the past released free response sections on the College Board's AP Central site, or you can reference a review resource such as Albert or your review book that might have a full-length practice test for you to check out. The key thing here is that you are mimicking the actual test environment, so you want to make sure that you are entirely focused as you're doing this diagnostic test and that you're allotting the same amount of time that you would have on test day as you're taking this diagnostic test. Step number 2 is to prioritize your study time. This will take you about 1 to 2 hours to do. The purpose of this step is for you to look at your diagnostic test and review what you got wrong and what you got right. Then from there, figure out where your weaknesses were and try to isolate for which topic areas your weaknesses mostly were in. From there, you'll be able to figure out which topics you have to spend a little bit more time on when it comes to your review. Make sure that as you review your free responses, that you are paying attention to those fine details in the scoring guidelines provided to you. Sometimes the College Board will give you points for XYZ, but not for ABC. So you're gonna wanna make sure that you are double checking the APES scoring guidelines very carefully as you review your example responses. By understanding where your weaknesses are from your diagnostic test, you can make better use of your study time so that you're not just trying to review everything you learned in AP Environmental Science when you have only a few hours to study for the exam. If you focus in on those weaknesses, then you can significantly increase your chances at scoring a 3, a 4, or a 5 on your AP Environmental Science exam. Albert can be a great resource for that, so be sure to check us out if you never have before to isolate for that sort of topic or unit level practice. The next step when it comes to preparing for your AP Environmental Science exam is to make a study calendar and stick to it. This is only going to take you about 20 minutes or so, but the purpose of this is to count down the number of days you have until your AP Environmental Science exam, and then to plan out how many study days you're going to be able to incorporate into your calendar. We recommend that you try to review at least 30 minutes a day as much as possible leading up to the months before the exam. The reason why is because by chunking it into these very bite-sized study sessions, it'll make it feel much more manageable for you to review everything that you've learned over the course of the school year in AP Environmental Science. It might also be helpful for you to find a friend and to have a study day together in terms of when you meet regularly on a weekly or bi-weekly basis to study for your APES exams. Before we head into step number 4 in our study plan, if you're finding this video helpful, do us a favor and hit that like button below. By doing so, you'll help this video get discovered by more AP students to help them prepare for their environmental science exam. Also, feel free to subscribe if you haven't already for more AP review content like this. Step number 4 when it comes to preparing for your AP Environmental Science exam is to brush up on tough concepts. This will take you 2 to 5 hours, and what we recommend you do here is that you reference a multitude of resources for you to get different perspectives about the different important topics in AP Environmental Science. Quenga.net is one of the best resources when it comes to finding more teacher slides, classroom notes, or just general study materials when it comes to AP Environmental Science. You might find use as well from checking out YouTube videos like Bozeman Science or Crash Course's AP Environmental Science review resources. Whatever you do to freshen up on these tough concepts in this step, the important thing is that you are applying what you identified in step number 2 of what your weaknesses were and truly trying to work through those weaknesses to not make those same mistakes come test day. Step number 5 is to make sure that you are honing your skills with lots and lots of practice questions. The reality of the AP Environmental Science exam is that more than half of your exam score comes from the multiple choice section. So this means that you have to get really familiar with the way that the College Board presents questions for you so that none of the questions that you see in the multiple choice section come as a surprise to you come test day. To do this, we recommend that you have a handy review resource, whether that's online or in an old school review book, that breaks things down by the different units of the exam. By having a resource like this, you'll be able to focus in on the areas that you are struggling with most. A resource like Albert can be super helpful here because we break things down by every single unit when it comes to AP Environmental Science. So for example, if you're struggling with Unit 3 on populations, you can just practice on populations-related practice questions. Step number 6 is to make sure that you are taking at least one more full-length practice exam. So this is going to take you at least 3 hours. And the reason for this is that after you've done all of this intensive review for AP Environmental Science, you want to see how you've grown from that first diagnostic test. As you take this second practice test, make sure that you're being super mindful as to how you're pacing in this test. Remember, when it comes to the multiple choice section, you're gonna have about a minute and 12 seconds to answer every single question that's presented to you. And when it comes to the free response section, you're gonna have about 23 minutes to complete each of those. As you can probably tell by now, practice makes perfect. So by applying the practice that we've done in a deliberate way as we prepare in this second time around, we're able to better position ourselves to score that 4 or 5. As you grade this practice test, ask yourself some questions like, which questions did you spend way too much time on? Or which questions did you find super easy? By asking these sorts of reflecting questions for yourself, you'll be able to better identify where to allocate the remaining study time that you may have before your AP Environmental Science exam. You're also going to want to make sure that you have a good system for identifying which questions you weren't sure about as you worked through the practice test so that you have enough time at the end of your multiple choice section to go back and reflect on those questions and give it a second try. Knowing your strengths and weaknesses is the key when it comes to feeling confident and prepared on test day. The final step when it comes to preparing for AP Environmental Science is to make sure that you are relaxing the day before the exam. This should take you at least 5 hours or so, and the main thing here is just to make sure that you are not being super intensive in your day before the exam final prep. Instead, just do some light review of some topics that you commonly get wrong, and then spend the rest of the time either hanging out with some friends, reading a book, or doing something that's just not remotely related to AP Environmental Science. Ultimately, you've already done all the prep work that you need to do if you followed the prior 6 steps, and so this time is for you to emotionally and mentally recharge before the actual test day. There you have it, 7 steps to help you study for your AP Environmental Science exam. If you found this video helpful, do us a favor and hit that like button below. And also consider subscribing if you found this sort of content helpful. We're gonna have follow-on videos where we do more in-depth breakdowns of different tips and tricks that you can take for the multiple choice and free response sections of your AP Environmental Science exam. If you haven't already, make sure that you sign up for your free account on Albert using the link in the video description below. With it, you'll get access to a couple of our practice questions and detailed explanations to help you prepare for your APES exam. And if you're a teacher happening to watch this video, be sure to check out our pilot program using the link in the video description below as well. By doing so, you'll be able to try us out for free for 30 days with your school. That's it for this time. In our next video, we're gonna break down some more AP Environmental Science study tips, so be sure to check that video out. In the meantime though, check out these videos that YouTube thinks you might like.